Beautiful presence was God was really here with us this morning. May take your seats, and we want to welcome all of you, our beloved NLCC family and friends of NLCC. Welcome and blessed Chinese New Year. And of course, we also want to welcome those of you who are streaming online, joining us in this service. And blessed CNY, and welcome to our combined Chinese ministry and English church CNY Sunday service. I believe all of us have been having our great time reunion and meeting up with our loved ones, relatives and friends during our CNY visitations, meeting up with a lot of our friends. But still, we need to really observe in full, yeah, the SOP practices like masking up and sanitizing, and of course observing the SOP. The cases are high, and we really urge all of us to take full precautions, yeah, practice and be responsible. If you have come into contact with someone who has been positive, and really to inform others so that you can do the necessary quarantining as well. All right, come, let's just any one of us who have a need for a touch of healing, can I just invite you to just stand? And those of you who are online, and just put up your hands, and as an acknowledgement of getting that you want that touch from the Lord as we pray for all of us. Come, let's just stand, those of you who need a touch from the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to bring before you, Lord, to your throne of grace, our brothers and sisters, Lord, who are standing, who have a need, Lord, for you to touch them physically, for that healing, O Lord, for their restoration. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, that they will receive your healing, Lord, by faith, and Lord, that they may find mercy and help in times of their need for their healing, Lord. Father, the Bible tells us in Psalm 46 that God is our refuge and strength, and a very present help in trouble. And Father, you are our Lord God who healed us. And Lord, we want to stand on these promises. We want to claim these promises, Lord, that even as our brothers and sisters stand to receive this touch, Lord, Father, that you will bring them, Lord, the required, Lord, help and restoration and healing, O Lord. Father, we thank you. Thank you for healing them. Thank you for touching them. And thank you for your grace and mercy and your healing upon each and every one of them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Those of you who will be traveling, or those of you who will be returning from your travels, from your hometowns, come, let's just stand as well as we pray this prayer of protections as you make your travels. Yeah, come, let's just stand. And of course, those who are online as well. Father, we want to commit all of our travelers who will be making their return trips from their outstation travel, or even making their trips back, Lord, to their hometowns. Father, we just pray, Lord, that your hand of protection will be upon them, O Lord. That, Father, that you will guide them, Lord, that may your presence always surround them, O Lord, bringing them back to their destination safely and being protected as well, O Lord, especially against COVID, O Lord. Father, we just thank you for making these travels possible for them during this season of CNY. And Father, we just want to praise you and thank you for guiding them and for protecting them and for bringing them back safely as well, O Lord. Lord, we just thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's just pray for our tithes and offering. And this Sunday being the first Sunday of the month, we usually do a collection. This is actually above and on top of the general offering that we are collecting, and this is for missions. Yeah, so come, let's just pray. And we want to thank God for being our Jehovah Jireh, God who provides. Father, we thank you, Lord, for being our God of providence, Lord. Father, you are our God who supplies all our needs, Lord, according to the riches of your glory in Christ Jesus. Father, we thank you that all that we have in our life, Lord, come from your hand. Lord, even as we bring our tithes and offering to your storehouse today, Lord, we want to give with love. We want to give with willingness. We want to give out of our obedience to you, Lord. Lord, may this giving and of tithes and offering be used for your kingdom's work in blessing those who are in it, and especially those in the mission and outreaches, Lord, that we are still able to extend and send our funds to them, O Lord. So help us, Lord, this day to give cheerfully and to tithe willingly. This we pray in the sweet name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. We want to welcome, especially those who are here with us for the first time visiting. I believe there are some of you. Can I just invite you to just stand? We want to pray. We want to welcome you, and we want to pray a prayer of blessing. Welcome, brothers and sisters. And any more who are here the first time, welcome, Karen. And any more? Maybe brother or Sian Mei? Is he here for the first time? No, okay, all right. Come, let's just stretch forth our hands as we pray for them, yeah? Father, we want to thank you for our brothers and sisters, Lord, who are here visiting, joining us in this combined CNY Sunday service. Father, as they are here, Father, may you speak to them. May you bring that word to them as they look to you, as they hear your word, O Lord. And also, Lord, as they are here with us, Father, may we extend our warm welcome, welcoming them, Lord, in this church, in this family, as we extend our love and greeting to them, O Lord. Father, we pray all this in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Can we have the announcement? Next Wednesday will be our first Wednesday of the month where we will meet physically for our prayer meets. So really want to encourage all of us to come and join us for our Wednesday prayer meeting here. There won't be a Zoom on the day that we are having our physical unless we are doing the live streaming, but we are not. So come and join us for the first Wednesday of the month for the physical prayer meet. I believe even as we come after week, as we pray, as we devote ourselves in our prayer meetings, in our prayers, God will be with us and He will bring answers to all that we pray for, yeah? So come, be encouraged and join us for this prayer meeting. And that's about all for the announcement. This Sunday, today we are very privileged to have Pastor Ben Yeap to be with us, be our speaker this Sunday. Pastor Ben was, I think he spent many years, he was under the drug addiction before he accepted the Lord and served in the Christian Drug Rehab Center, and also responded to the call of God serving in FGA Penang for pastoring there for 2 years before God called him again to lead RCC, yeah, Renewal Christian Church in Penang, Bukit Metajam. I think RCC is 26 years old, the same age as NLCC, yeah. And of course, Pastor Ben has been joining us and even going. I think the first trip that he made to Myanmar was in 2008 with Pastor Titi, serving and reaching out to the Myanmaris. And today we are very proud to say that we are partners, yeah, in serving in this ministry as well. And I remember Pastor Ben shared this during his time when he was when his sister sent him to care center, yeah, admitting him to care center, and he was actually making his escape. You know, his sister actually took all the trouble to really send him, and that was really the only hope for him at that time, coming out from drug addiction. And on that night, he was actually preparing his escape, and this Bible verse, Isaiah 40 verse 14, "They who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength," was on the wall. And on that night, when it was all dark, he was planning his escape the next morning, or rather that night itself, this verse he read, and also the song that he could sing, but he actually refused to sing. But when he read this verse, he sang and he stayed on care center, and he went through that program and the time. And today he's a renewed man. Today he's a transformed man. And today God has change him to a new man. And we are very excited to hear his sermon. And together with Pastor Ben today, we also want to welcome Karen. Yeah, Karen is happily married to Pastor Ben, and between them they have 4 children. So today is he's going to preach in Mandarin, and will be translated by Sister Jack. So can we welcome Pastor Ben on stage and Sister Jacqueline as well?
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone.
我应该是在2019年来过。
I think I came here in 2019.
那个时候是宣教周。
That was like a mission month. Yeah.
那今天早上呢，能够在我们华人的过年期间来跟大家拜年。
Yeah. This morning is a very privileged to be able to come during the Chinese New Year to bring the greeting of Chinese New Year to all.
那我们还没开始之前，我们先来做个祷告。
Let's pray.
主耶稣，我们再一次带着感恩的心，在你的同在中仰望你。
Lord, we just want to give you thanks and want to come into your presence to honor you and to worship you.
主，让这一段时间让我们都能够敞开我们的心。
Lord, may this time you open our heart.
求主您的灵带领我们。
Let your Holy Spirit bring us and lead us.
让我们能够更明白您的话语。
Let us be able to have the understanding of your word.
也让我们能够反映在您自己的话语中。
And let us be able to respond to your word this morning.
听我们的祷告，奉耶稣基督的名。
This we pray in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. 好，我们来看我们今天的讲题。
Let's look at today's topic.
那就是关灯。
Yes, light off.
我每一年呢，都会在年尾的时候，我都会寻求上帝，新的一年，你给我一个亮光。
Yeah, every year at the end of the year, I will spend some days to be in the presence of God to ask for His direction for next coming year.
所以在2019年的时候呢，我问上帝说：“2020年，你怎么的带领我？”
Yeah, in year 2019, I asked the Lord, "What? How you going to lead me in 2020?"
所以他给我的那个的方向就是，惊慌 panicking.
No, in year 2020, the Lord gave the word panicking.
所以我们知道2020就是我们面对了这一个的新冠肺炎的这一个的时刻。
As you all know, 2020 was the year that we faced the pandemic.
然后到了2020年尾的时候，我再一次的跟我在寻求神的时候说，那2021年你给我什么样的一个的亮光？
In year 2020, I asked the Lord again, what do you have for us in 2021?
他跟我说的是复活 resurrection.
Yeah, the Lord said resurrection.
那当然，今天我不能够跟你们讲了有关于19年、20年我所听到的 ，OK。
So today I won't be able to share all 2020 all the years.
那接着下来呢，在2021年尾的时候，我再一次的寻求神，我说：“那2022年我们又该如何的面对？”
Yeah, end of last year, I asked the Lord again in 2022, how are you going to direct us?
那这一次呢，他就真的是给我一个 shock， 就是关灯。
This is a shock to me with the word light off.
So 我们来看一下为什么上帝跟我说关灯。
Let's see what the Lord say about light off.
Next， 那我们从约翰福音第9章第4节呢看的时候。 圣经是这样写着，他说：“趁着白日，我们必须做那差我来者的工；黑夜将到，就没有人能做工了。”
John chapter 9 verse 4: I must work the works of Him who sent me. While it is day, the night is coming when no one can work.
这段经文非常的清楚 ，OK。 然后呢，我们再看约翰福音12章35节呢，同样的也是耶稣说。 耶稣对他们说：“光在你们中间，还有不多的时候，应当趁着有光行走，免得黑暗临到你们。那在黑暗里行走的，不知道往何处去。”
Yeah, the next verse that God given us is John 12 verse 3. Then Jesus said to them, "A little while longer, the light is with you. Walk while you have the light." lest darkness overtake you. He who walks in darkness does not know where he is going.
那我用那个红字呢？我红色的字就是要我 highlight， 就是让你们去注意的。
Look at those highlighted in red words.
那我们再来，接下来。
Like scene.
这边呢，我所把它用红字写起来，就是白日做工，做正确的事。
Yeah, those that highlighted is mentioned in the day we work and do the right thing.
Okay, 这个就是约翰福音九章第四节他说的白日。那就是要我们在白日做工，那就是要做正确的事。
In the book of John, it states, in the day we must work and work, do the right work.
Do the right things. Okay, 再来 ，next， 在约翰福音的接下来的十二章，他说的是，我把它 highlight 起来，就是有光行走往正确的方向。
Yeah, in the John 12, it says that when you walk, you go to the light and go to the right direction.
So, 这两节的经文呢，它有两个很好的意思。
Yeah, these two verses has a very public connection.
Yeah, 一个就是白日做工。
One is day you work.
黑夜不能做了。
In the dark, you can't work.
我们现在现代的时刻，我们有灯可以，不过在当时是不能的。
Yeah, during that time there wasn't light at night.
然后呢，他说有光的时候你要行走。
Yeah, when there is light, you walk.
那你要走的就是正确的方向。
And you walk to the right direction.
Okay, next, 为什么
？Why?
什么是做正确的事，往正确的方向？
What is doing the right things and going to the right direction?
我相信我们为什么今天要来教会
？Yeah, why we coming to church today?
那当然，我们来教会最重要的，我个人觉得 ，as a 做了牧师三十多年，我觉得来教会最重要的事情就是来纪念主。
Yeah, for me as a pastor for many years to come to church is to honor God to remember the Lord.
为什么叫主日？
Why is it called Day of the Lord?
为什么我们不守安息日
？Why we do not
keep the Sabbath?
Keep the Sabbath day.
Okay, 我们称它为主日 ，the Lord's day.
We call it the Lord's day.
那就是因为这个今天 Sunday 星期日是主复活的早上。
Yeah, because Sunday is the day of resurrection for the Lord.
所以我们称它为主日。
That's why we call it the Lord's Day.
我们不守安息日。
We do not observe Sabbath.
那主耶稣在圣经里面呢，他交代亲自交代我们的两件事。
Yeah, Jesus have remind us for two things.
他说你们要纪念我。
You must remember me.
就是我们掰饼喝杯，他说你要纪念我。
You must remember me.
第二个呢？当他复活的时候呢，他就跟那个玛利亚 Mary Magdalene 说：“你去告诉我的门徒，叫他们在加利利等我。”
When he resurrected, he told Mary Magdalene to go to the disciple to ask the disciple to wait for him at Galilee.
所以主日呢，就是今天我们来纪念主。
Yeah, the Lord's Day is the day where we come to to remember the Lord.
然后他吩咐他的门徒要在加利利等他。
And he instructed the disciple to wait upon him at Galilee.
那今天主复活了，他叫我们在教会等他。
Today the Lord has resurrected and he asked us to wait upon him in his house.
那我们在他的家纪念他。
In his house we worship him, we remembering him.
那今天呢，我们必须要用live 直播。
Today we need to use live streaming.
我想问的是，你在家你有准备纪念主吗？
I just want to ask you a question. Do you remembering the Lord and worship the Lord in your house?
当然，在 lockdown 的时候，我们没有办法来教会聚会。
During the lockdown, we have no choice but to worship the Lord at home.
不过现在我们可以实体聚会了。
Now we can come back to physical service.
我想呢，我们不可以被这一个恶者的 deception， 恶者的一个的欺骗。
We do not want to be deceived by the evil one.
我们在家久了，我们的赞美敬拜啊，我们听到啊，或者是我们守圣餐啊，我们是不是很随便的呢？
When we worship the Lord at home for such a long time, we take it very lightly, all the our worship, our communion with the Lord.
我们刚才在这边实体的聚会的赞美敬拜和在家里面的赞美敬拜，你觉得会一样吗？
Would it be a different as we worship the Lord in His house and worship the Lord in our own home?
我觉得是不一样的。
I think it's very, very different.
我们在这边拍手，你在家能拍手吗？
We clap hand here. Do you clap hand at home?
我们举我们的手赞美，陶醉在上帝的同在中，你能吗？
We lift up our hands in this place, but do you lift up your hands at home?
可能你说你能，我也不知道。
Yeah, maybe you can. I don't know.
不过当我在 lockdown 的时候 as a pastor 一个牧师我在家里面的赞美敬拜我也觉得很显呢。
Even for me as a pastor when I worship at home I felt that dryness as well、啊、
那有时候呢听到的时候听了想到哎呀喝咖啡又去冲一杯咖啡
Even during listening to the sermon if I need a coffee I'll just go and make a coffee
不过现在 你想到喝咖啡不能了吗你还不是要坐坐听我讲
But that you are in here you can't do that you have to listen to me
So是不一样的。
It's very, very different.
所以我们为什么要来教会，就是要来纪念主、敬拜主、聆听主。
Yeah, why we come to the church is to remembering the Lord, worshiping the Lord, listen to the Lord.
希望呢，我们已经在这样的一个的lockdown 的环境中两年了，不要养成了坏习惯。
Yeah. So we do not allow this lockdown to build a bad habit in us.
它不应该是这样的。
It won't be. It's should not be like this.
这两年的这个 lockdown 的这两年呢，是给我们基督徒呢，我们信心的一个考验。
Yeah, these 2 years of lockdown is actually a testing of our faith.
两年过后，我还是这样的爱主。
After 2 years, I still very fervent for the Lord.
两年过后，环境不能改变我对主的信心。
After 2 years, the environment and the situation will not affect my faith in the Lord.
我们读书都要考试的嘛。
Even in school, you need to go through an exam.
最难的就是 Form 6的两年 ，Form 6就考了进大学嘛。
The worst one was the Form 6 exam. It's the hardest.
那我觉得两年的 Form 6 lockdown Form 6我们要进大学。
After the lockdown, we are going to the uni.
那我们再来看。
Let's see.
那我们看到说，为什么上帝会说关灯
？Why the Lord say light off？
那刚才我们也看到了，还没有关灯之前，我们要做正确的事，走正确的方向。
Before the light off, we must do the right things and we must walk the right direction.
这也就是上帝给我的这段经文呢，鼓励了我。
In this verse, the Lord encouraged me.
这个就是出埃及记十章二十一节耶和华对摩西说你向天伸杖使埃及地黑暗这黑暗似乎摸得着二十二节摩西向天伸杖埃及地遍地就乌黑了三天二十三三天之久人不能相见谁也不敢起来离开本处唯有以色列人家中都有亮光
Exodus chapter 10, verse 21, Then the Lord said to Moses, Stretch out your hand towards heaven, and there may be darkness over the land of Egypt, darkness which may even be felt. So Moses stretched out his hand towards heaven, and there was thick darkness in all the land of Egypt 3 days. They did not see one another, nor did anyone rise from his place for 3 days, but all the children of Israel had light in their dwellings.
3 days, 整个的埃及呢都黑暗。
The whole Egypt was in darkness.
只有以色列家有光。
Only the house of the Israelites had the light.
在这个三天的黑暗里面呢，埃及人都不敢起来。
In these 3 days of darkness, the Egyptian, dare not rise up.
我相信这个就是为什么上帝要关灯的理由。
That's the reason why the Lord want to light off.
让我们基督徒呢，他的儿女呢，我们做好了准备。
It's for us as the children of God to prepare ourselves.
那上帝要关灯，他已经告诉我们。
The Lord said He will light off. He told us.
当他关灯的时候呢，全地黑暗，以色列地有光。
When the light off, the whole world will be in darkness, but the house of the Israelite has light.
那这个光到底对我们说了什么？
Yeah, what does this light mean to us?
我们再看另外一段的经文。再来 ，next。你看《撒母耳记上》二章第九节，他必保护圣民的脚步，使恶人在黑暗中寂然不动，人都不能靠力量得胜。
In 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 9, he will guard the feet of his saints, but the wicked shall be silent in darkness. For by strength, no man shall prevail.
那刚才我们说了，黑暗还没来到之前
，Before the darkness come。
我们还在光中，我们要做正确的事，走正确的方向。
We are still in the light. We do the right thing and we walk the right direction.
为什么呢
？Why？
因为在黑暗的时刻呢
？Because in darkness.
这边说，上帝要在黑暗的时候保护我们。
The Lord said He will protect us in the dark.
他关灯，他保护我们。
He light off, but His protection upon us.
不过呢，恶人就是我们的敌人呢，在黑暗中寂然不动。
But our enemies cannot move in the dark.
这个就是上帝为什么要关灯的理由。
That's the reason why the Lord must light off.
然后你再看约伯记二十九章第三节，那时他的灯照在我头上，我借他的光行过黑暗。
In Job 29 verse 3, when his lamp shone upon my head, and when it by his light I walked through the darkness.
撒母耳说。他会保护我们，关灯的时候他会保护我们。
In 1 Samuel, the Lord said He will protect us in darkness.
然后敌人不能动。
And our enemies cannot move.
然后在约伯记说，他的光要照在我们的头上。
In Book of Job, He said that His light, His lamp will shine upon our head.
然后呢，我们就借着他的光，我们借着他的光行过黑暗。
We walk through the darkness by the light.
我这样讲还是全部都是字。
And I say all these are all words.
我们还看不到什么。
We can't see anything.
那我们再看下去，另外一段神的话，诗篇119:105，我们很喜欢的。嗯。等一下，那个等一下，wait. Okay, let this verse.
Psalm 119 verse 105. Your words is the lamp to my feet and the light to my path. We love this verse.
我们很喜欢的，我们都常常用的啊。这个是你的话是我脚前的灯，是我路上的光。
Yeah, we always use these words and we love these words.
不过你必须要看104，你没有看104呢，你根本不知道它的意思在哪里。Yeah,
but we need to look at the verse before this verse.
看。119:104，我借着你的训词得以明白，所以我恨一切的假道。
In verse 104, through the precept I get understanding, therefore I hate every false way.
See, 我借着你的训词
through your precept,
我恨一切的假道。
I hate every false way.
然后105，你的话是我脚前的灯，是我路上的光。
Then we come to 105. Your words is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path.
那刚才我们说呢，约伯记的时候，他的光照在我头上，我才能够借着他的光行过黑暗。
Just now in Book of Job, through his light we can walk through the darkness.
他的光照在我头上。
His light shining upon my head.
什么呢？就是这边说，我借着你的训词 ，the word of God。
From here we can see the word of God is the precept that we get understanding。
若是没有上帝的训词照在我们的头上，我们没有了神的话呢，我们不能恨这个世界的假道。
Without the word of God, we cannot hate every false way in this world。
那我们再从耶稣怎么讲，我们学习圣经真理和世界知识。
Let's look at the teaching of Jesus of about the world and his truth.
那意思就是说，圣经知识和这个世界的知识。
Yeah, the word from the Bible and the knowledge of the world.
Okay, 有什么的相冲突的地方吗？
What is the conflict?
那么我们看这个就是耶稣用的比喻。
Let's look at how Jesus explained.
马太福音九章十六节，没有人把新布补在旧衣服，因为所补上的凡带坏了那衣服，破的就更大了。十七，也没有人把新酒装在旧皮袋里，若是这样，皮袋就裂开，酒漏出来，连皮袋也坏了。唯独把新酒装在新皮袋里，两样都保全了。
Matthew chapter 9 verse 16. No one puts a piece of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, for the patch pulls away from the garment, and the tear is made worse. Nor do they put new wine into old wineskin, or else the wineskin break and the wine is spilled, and the wineskin are ruined, but they put the new wine into a new wineskin, and both are preserved.
那简单来说，简单来说呢，就是圣经的真理和我们一切所学习在这个世界上的知识。
The truth in the Bible and the knowledge that we learn through the world from the world.
Yeah, nothing wrong. 没有问题的。
Yeah, there's nothing wrong about it.
不过呢，你若是没有把两样弄得很好的话
，But if you do not put both together in the right way，
就好像耶稣说的，你不能够把新布放在旧衣服，它会扯破。
Yeah, just as how Jesus has said, you cannot put the old garment into a new cloth.
Yeah, then the old cloth, the new.
Yeah, it will tear away the garment and it will make it worse.
那也就是说呢，今天呢，你不能够从圣经知识里面学习。
You cannot learn from the Bible.
你这个人不改变。
And you do not change.You do not transform.
如果你有圣经知识，可是你的生活生命不改变
，If you have the word of God but you never change,
它会把你撕掉。
It will tear you off.
就好像那个新酒，你放在旧皮袋里
，It's like the new wine you put into the old wine skin.
他说连皮袋也坏了
，Even the wine skin will be tear off.
我们不能够呢来教会认识了圣经，然后我们回到这个世界，用这个世界的方法生活。
We cannot learn the truth from the Bible, and when we go back to the world, we live as if there is no truth in from the Bible, and live the same life.
Yeah, 迟早你一定会把整个的生命搞坏了。
Sooner or later, your life will be destroyed.
所以他最后他说，唯独把新酒装在新皮袋里，两样都保全了。
Only when the new wine into the new wine skin, both will be preserved.
那有时候我们会听到一些的基督徒啊，他们会讲，哎呀，牧师啊，做基督徒很难的。
You will hear from some Christians and say that being a Christian is so hard.
哦，这个不能，这个不能，这个不可以，那个不可以。哎呦，没有自由嘞！
There will be no freedom because we cannot do many things.
我以前呢，没有信耶稣更方便嘞，我什么都可以。现在我什么都不可以。
Before I became a Christian, it would be better because I can do everything. Now there's so much of restriction.
哎，好像我们信耶稣的时候，牧师跟我讲，信了耶稣很自由的哦。
But the pastor told me after become a Christian, we will be set free.
可是好像。你们骗我呢？我信了耶稣就更加不自由哎。
Sound like I'm being trapped.
No, 不是的。我们再看一下 next。哥罗西书三章第十节，穿上了新人，这新人在知识上渐渐更新，正如照他主的形象。
In Colossians 3:10 and have put on the new man who is renewed in knowledge according to the image of him who created him.
他说穿上了新人。
Yeah, he said, put on a new man.
刚才讲的那个旧衣服要脱掉咯。
Yeah, your old clothes have to thrown away.
啊，你要穿上新人。
You have to put on your new man.
那就是我们以前的生活，以前的知识呢，慢慢你要把它拿下来的。
Meaning that all our old knowledge, we need to remove it bit by bit.
那我用比较简单一点的方法来说。
Let me simplify it.
simplify. Yes, correct. You are right. 那我们常常我们基督徒呢会说，哎呀，不可以做这个啊，不可以做那个啊，不可以抽烟啊，不可以喝酒啊，不可以骂脏话，哎，很多不可以啊。
When you become a Christian, you always hear we cannot smoke, we cannot drink, we cannot tell lies, we cannot say bad words. There are many things that we cannot do.
我不再这样教导。
I don't teach them like this anymore.
我已经二三十年不再向教会的弟兄姐妹说，不可以这个，不可以这个，我已经不再这样做了。
For the past 20 over years, I don't teach my people like this.
啊，牧师可以啊。
Then, Pastor, can I do all these things?
我不要。
I don't want.
It's not I can.
Yeah.
I don't want.
I don't want to do.
我教我的孩子呢，小的时候我会跟他讲 cannot。 当他长大了，他会跟我讲我不要。
When my children was young, I would tell them not to do this, not to do that. But when they grown up, they will tell me they do not want to do it.
我的孩子今年30岁了，我还跟他讲，哎 ，Brian， 不可以啊，不可以啊，不可以，烦死了咯。
My son is 30 years old now. I can't tell him and nag at him like this.
我小的时候把他教的好好的那个根基，他现在不会去说不可以，他会说我不要。
Because of my teaching to him when he was young, he will reject all this.
我们基督徒很喜欢跟人家做见证，我们基督徒我们不抽烟的，我们基督徒我们不喝酒的。
When we go out and share the gospel, we always like to show that we don't do, we don't drink, we don't smoke.
We always say, Christian don't smoke, man. Christian don't drink. No lah, any normal person also don't drink and smoke. 很多普通人都不喝酒、不抽烟的，不必是基督徒来的。
Not only Christian don't smoke and don't drink, there are many people that are not drinking and not smoking.
我觉得呢，这个就是叫做我们要穿上新的人，脱去旧的人。
This is what we say, that put on the new man and remove the old man.
他说怎样穿上呢？我们这个新人呢，在知识上渐渐更新。
Yeah, how do we put on the new man? In this word, it say in the knowledge, we renew ourselves.
我们基督徒怎么样的能够继续的成熟到说我不要？
Yeah, how can we mature until the stage that we can say we do not want?
不是不可以。
It's not we can't.
不可以是我限制你的。
Yeah, when I say you cannot means that I restrict you.
当你讲不要，是你做主的。
Yeah, when you say I do not want, it's your decision.
我觉得我们基督徒应该是自己说，我不要去卡拉OK，我不要去，我不要。
As a Christian, we must say that we do not want to be participate in the world practices.
而不是我们的，我们基督徒不可以，我们 no, 我不要。
Yeah, it's not I cannot, but I do not want to.
所以我觉得这个就是，上帝的话语呢，在我们的思想里面
，The word of God come into our mind，
我们才能够拒绝这个世界的假道
，Then only we can reject the false teaching of the world。
Psalm 119:4。啊，就是刚才的诗篇1104，然后有了诗篇1904，我们才能够有诗篇1905。 他的话也是我脚前的灯，是我路上的光，好吗？
Yeah, then only we can use the word of God as our the lamp to our feet and light to our path.
如果你没有104，你怎么会有105呢？
If you do not have the words 104, how can we have that promises of 105?
我们很喜欢105。
We love the words in 119 and verse 105.
你的话也是我脚前的灯，是我路上的光。
We always claim that.
不过重要的是104
But the important one in verse 104
那就是叫我们穿上新的人，让这个新人在知识上
Yeah, that's the words that to teach us to put on the new man and renew our knowledge in the Lord and in His image.
那这个新的知识在哪里学习？
Where do we get this new knowledge?
如果我们没有教会，没有来教会，
If you don't come to the church,
叫你自己在家里面 Bible study 能吗？
You do your own Bible study at home.
很难，不是不能，很难。
You can, but it's a bit difficult and tough.
所以呢，来教会我们有这样的讲道解经。
Yeah, when you come to the church, you have the preaching of the words and you learn.
我们祷告会小组，那我们就有更多圣经知识罩在我们的头上。
We come to the prayer meeting, we come to cell group, that we have put in the new knowledge of the Lord in our mind.
那我们才能够先穿上这个旧的衣服，才能够拿掉啊。
Then only we can put on the new man and let go of the old man.
不然的话，圣经知识进来，可是呢，旧衣服没有脱去啊。
But if the teaching of the word of God came into our mind, but we still have our old man, it cannot bring transformation.
他会打架。
It will fight and have a conflict between us. Within us.
衣服会破。
Then the your clothes will be tear.
那也就是说，你信耶稣到了某一段时间呢，你不想来教会了。
Then until certain time when you become a Christian, you don't feel like coming to church.
啊。在你的公司里面给老板骂。
In your office when you are scolded by your boss.
在家里面给爸爸妈妈骂。
At home you'll be scolded by your parents.
好不容易星期天不必见到老板，又不必见到爸爸妈妈，还来教会给牧师骂。不要啦。
Yeah, and it's so difficult to come to Sunday where we can have the rest from the boss and the parents. And why should I come to church?
Being rebuked by the pastor.
Being rebuked by the pastor. Yes.
Okay, 我们再来 next.那么为什么黑暗之灾要在杀长子之灾前面呢？
Why should the plague of darkness precede the plague of killing of the firstborn?
好，刚才我们看的那个黑暗之灾是第九灾哦。
Just now when we see the plague of darkness was the ninth plague.
然后接下来就是杀长子之灾第十灾。
Followed by that will be the plague of killing the firstborn.
所以呢，你看出埃及记十章二十一节的时候，耶和华跟摩西说：“你向天伸杖，使埃及地黑暗，这黑暗似乎摸得着。”
Exodus chapter 10 verse 21. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand towards heaven, that there may be darkness over the land of Egypt, darkness which may even be felt."
Darkness 虽然黑暗，不过呢，还是摸得到的。
Yeah, even in the darkness, you can still feel.
现在呢，我们说把灯全部关起来。
If we off all the light here,
那一下子呢，我们全部什么都看不到。
Yeah, for a moment we can't see anything.
不过你只要过了三分钟、四分钟
，After three, four minutes,
我开始可以看到了。Then 我适应黑暗了。
You get used to the darkness and you start to see things.
所以呢，这一个黑暗呢，之灾并没有吓到。埃及人
yeah, this plate of darkness did not
very scared the Egyptian.
Scared off the Egyptian.
没有哦，所以呢，法老一直反悔。
That's why pharaohs keep regretting.
我们再看下去，再来。那你今天拥有的心是法老的心呢，还是接下来是摩西的心
？Yeah, is the heart of you today is the heart of Pharaoh or is it the heart of Moses?
看呢，摩西的心。The heart of Moses.
The heart of Moses.
上帝跟他说，第一灾去跟法老讲，第一灾。
And the Lord told Moses the first plague. Tell Pharaoh.
摩西一定会以为，嚯，第一灾你怕不怕
？Yeah. Moses will be very very proud that he was scared the Pharaoh.
Yeah. 法老不怕。
But Pharaoh do not scared.
上帝说第二灾。
Then God sent the second plague.
摩西讲。这一次看你怕不怕
yeah, Moses said, this time Pharaoh will be afraid.
法老不怕。
But Pharaoh do not afraid.
反反复复直到第九灾法老一直的灾后反复的后悔。
Yeah, Pharaoh keep back and forth for nine times and he regretted, but he still hold back the Israelite.
如果我是摩西啊。
If I'm Moses,
我一想，上帝啊，他都不怕了，你还继续做下去做什么
？God, why you continue to send the plague while the Pharaoh do not afraid?
上帝没有跟摩西讲第十灾他就怕了，没有哦。
Yeah, God didn't tell Moses that the tenth plague will get Pharaoh's afraid.
摩西行了一灾，他又不怕两灾，又不怕三灾，又不怕。摩西讲，到底行不行
？After so many times of plague, Moses will question, "Is it work? Does it work?"
摩西的心里面没有怀疑神哦。
Moses never doubt God.
那把我们放在摩西的方面。
If we put ourselves in Moses' shoes,
我看我们灰心了。
I think we will be discouraged.
上帝啊，我祷告那么多次了都没有的。
Lord, I pray, I've been praying, but I don't see the answer. 啊，
我为我丈夫祷告，他还是这样死样的。
I pray for my husband, but he's still the same.
啊，我为我孩子这样祷告，他越祷告越变本加厉了。
I pray for my children, it get worse.
摩西没有
，But Moses did not.
他还是相信上帝。
He still believed that the power of God.
不过法老的心呢就不一样了。
But Pharaoh's heart is very different.
你行了一个神迹，是啦，是辛苦一点啦。
He experienced the miracle.
Though got some problem lah.
Though he faced some problem.
But he 法老可以随随便便的就。哎呀呀！推翻他曾经答应的，他就推翻了。
Yeah, Pharaoh's heart is always regretted after he make the decision, and he go back and forth.
所以我再推翻多一次也是这样啊。
Yeah, if I reject one more time, it's still the same.
所以有时候呢，我们基督徒呢，不要养成了有法老的心。
So as a Christian, we do not want our heart to be like Pharaoh's heart.
有时候呢，你犯了罪。
When you sin against God,
然后呢，你 repent 啦，哦，你悔改啦。
When you repent,
悔改了，悔改了，又再回来。
Then you do it again.
然后又再悔改。
Then you repent, back and forth.
哦，很爽这样的。然后有时候我们会觉得什么都没有事。
Then we will feel like, nothing happened. I still the sick. I still okay.
啊，我犯罪了。Okay.
I sin against God, but I'm still okay.
你看扫罗王 King Saul.
You look at King Saul.
上帝跟撒母耳说，跟 Saul King Saul 讲说，我废了你为王。
The Lord told Samuel to tell Saul, I will take you down from the kingship.
可是呢，撒母耳讲过后呢，扫罗王去打仗，每一次打仗他还是打赢啊。
Yeah, after this Saul go to the war, he still win the war.
你和我犯罪了，主啊，原谅我。Still everything okay 哦。
Yeah, when I sin against God, I just repent and everything will be okay.
甚至有时候我们犯罪了，我们连悔改都没有悔改，还是 okay 哦。
Sometimes we don't even repent, but we still okay.
牧师呢，站在讲台讲到了，可是。犯罪中嘞，祷告还是人家祷啊。
Even for pastor, sin against God, they can still preach the words, and when he pray, they can still see people can slain and miracle can happen.
滥用神的恩典啊。
This is we
take grace for granted.
Yeah, take grace of God for granted.
上帝没有那么小气的。
God is very generous.
啊。不会因为你犯了一点的罪，然后他就惩罚你。
He won't discipline you or destroy you just because you have a little sin.
所以呢，我们不能够因为上帝的慈爱，我们的心变成了法老的心。
We cannot misuse the goodness and the mercy of God and have a heart of Pharaoh.
我们应该好像摩西。不管如何，我的祷告他有没有听没有关系，我还是相信他是神。
We must have a heart of Moses. Even though we don't see prayer answer, we don't see miracle, we will still have faith in the Lord. We trust in the Lord.
So, 这个就是上帝给了这个黑暗之灾三天过后，埃及人好像还是能够摸得着哦。
After 3 days of darkness, the Egyptian will be able to see around and move around.
上帝的慈爱临到基督徒和非基督徒。
The love of God come upon the Christian and non-Christian.
上帝的慈爱临到基督徒，使基督徒更爱他。
The love of God come upon the Christian so that we Christian can love him more.
上帝的慈爱也临到非基督徒。
When the love of God come upon the non-believer.
不过呢，非基督徒的心会越来越硬。
The heart of the non-believer will get hardened.
这就是圣经说，上帝使法老的心硬。
This is why the Lord say, "I harden the heart of Pharaoh."
不是上帝 harden 他的 heart 啊，不是上帝赐法老的心硬， yeah, 不是，
no.
是在恩典中法老的心越来越硬，摩西的心越来越温柔。
Yeah, that's the difference of Pharaoh's heart and Moses' heart. When the love of and the mercy of God come upon Pharaoh, his heart hardened, but Moses' heart become more and more loving to God and trust in the Lord.
同样，今天坐在这里，你若是有好像摩西的心。你听了神的话，你会越来越爱主。
Yeah, likewise for us, when we have the heart of Moses, when we hear the word of God, we will love the Lord even more deeper.
如果我们今天呢是滥用恩典，那我们越听上帝越多的恩典呢的话语呢，你的心会越来越硬。
Yeah, likewise, if we misuse the grace of God, we take the grace of God for granted, our heart will be hardened like Pharaoh.
可能我在这边讲，你在下面听。
I'm standing here to speak, and you hear from the congregation.
Yeah, you 在那边讲那么多，我犯罪也不是这样，都没有死。
Yeah, even for myself, I never die. Also, I sin against God. I'm still here.
The heart of Pharaoh,
That's the heart of Pharaoh.
Ah, 你跟我的心不一样喽。我们有摩西的心，你有法老的心哦。
That's the difference of Moses' heart and Pharaoh's heart.
所以你还没有死。
So you're still around, you're not died yet.
所以这个就是第九灾的 night plague.
This is the night plague that
因为过后就是第十灾 the ten plague.
After the night plague will be the ten plague.
Next. 所以呢，第十灾是什么灾呢？
What is the ten plague?
杀长子之灾。
Killing of firstborn.
今天什么是杀长子之灾？
Today is the plate of killing of firstborn.
What is the meaning of killing of the firstborn today? 今天杀长子之灾对我们是什么意思呢？
What is the meaning of the ten plate for us today?
不再是我们的孩子的死。
It's not about the death of our children, our firstborn.
它是我们的钱财的问题。
It's about our money.
我觉得上帝所要关灯呢。他就是在告诉我们经济的关灯。
When the Lord said the light off, I believe is the meaning of light off in our economy.
Yeah. 所以我相信不久呢，上帝会关灯，经济会是一片的黑暗。
I believe the next plate will be on our economy.
当然，我也看到上帝的话给我们的就是。你要兴起发光，因为你的光已经来到。耶和华的荣耀发现照耀你。看啊，黑暗遮盖大地，幽暗遮盖万民，耶和华却要显现照耀你。他的荣耀要现在你的身上，万国要来救你的光，君王要来救你发现的光辉。
In Isaiah 60 verse 1, Arise, shine, for your light has come.And the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and deep darkness the people. But the Lord will arise over you, and his glory will be seen upon you. And the Gentiles shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising.
那我简单的来讲解一下，简单的讲解啊。
Let me explain this.
神说，兴起。
The Lord say, arise.
为什么呢？
Why?
他叫我们兴起发光。
The Lord asks us to arise and shine.
因为他说，因为你的光来到。
Because the Lord say the light has come.
那意思就是说呢，今天你坐着，你不兴起，那个光来到照不到你啊。
Oh, that means that if you do not arise when the light come, it cannot shine upon you.
你不能发光哦。
You cannot shine.
所以我们要兴起，因为光来了，你才能够发光啊。
Yeah, so first we must arise.
如果你没有兴起，没有光哦。
If you do not arise, you do not have the light.
所以今天他说我要关灯，那就是我要兴起哦。
When the Lord say he want to light off, means that he want to arise.
The Lord said he's going to light off. We need to arise.
We need to arise.
Then only we can shine. If you don't arise, when the light comes, you don't arise, there's no light to shine. So, 我们今天呢，我回到我刚才所用的经文。那就是说，当黑暗来的时候呢， 我们对不起，当白天的时候呢，我们要做正确的事，走在正确的方向。
So refer to the verses before. When there is light, we do the right thing and they walk the right direction.
Okay. 哦，当还是白天的时候嘛。
When there is day.
那也就是说呢，你有了这个的习惯。
You build this habit.
当你有了这个白天的好习惯。
When you have the day habit that you walk and you work.
你来教会纪念主。敬拜主，聆听主。
You come to the house of the Lord. You remember him. You worship him. You listen to his word.
所以，他已经成为了我的习惯，在白天。
It become a habit that built in us.
当黑暗来的时候，我还是有这个习惯。
When the darkness come, I still doing the same thing.
所以呢，第九灾就好像上两年的 lockdown.
The ninth plague is like the 2 years lockdown.
你若是之前没有了这样子来敬拜主、聆听主、纪念主的习惯 ，lockdown 两年什么都没有了。
If you do not build this habit of remembering the Lord, worship the Lord, listening to His word, the 2 years lockdown will destroy you.
Why 没有习惯吗
？Because you do not build that habit.
你平时也没有来教会的。
Yeah, you don't come to church.
苏干苏干，你来教会了。
You don't commit yourself to come to the church.
有什么事情你就不来教会了
？When something happen, you don't come to the church.
你不能够坚持来教会，建立了这样的好习惯的。
You cannot persistent in your habit.
所以呢，两年 lockdown 没有了咯。
That's why after 2 years of lockdown, there's no more relationship with.
那为什么今天还有那么多人在这边呢？
Why we have so many of you around here today?
因为你有习惯吗
Because you already built the habit.
你多么的想回来啊
You so look forward to come back to the house of God.
分别就在这边哦
That's the difference.
所以现在还是白天，上帝还没有关灯哦
Now it's still day. The Lord has not light off.
所以我们现在要在白天的时候建立这样的好习惯
So we must build this good habit during the day.
前两年 lockdown 两年，那是一个 pre， 那是一个演戏而已。
The 2 years is just a pre and it's just a preparation.
好，那就是第九灾，黑暗之灾。
That's the plate of darkness.
然后只有在教会有亮光。
It's only when you come to the house of God that is light.
啊，第九灾的时候，全埃及没有光，只有以色列地有光。
Yeah, during the plate of darkness, the whole world has darkness, but only the Israelite dwelling has the light.
在这个第九灾将要开始的时候呢，只有在教会有光。
In this night plate, the darkness only in the house of the Lord you see the light.
我们要来教会，让神的光照在我们的头上。
So that's why we must come to the house of the Lord so that the light will shine upon our head.
我们必须有神的话语圣经在我们的思想里面。
We must put the word of God into our mind.
所以呢，我们才能够借着神的话语否决了这个世界的假道。
So that we can receive the light and the truth of the Lord from his word to face the false teaching of the world.
Yeah.我们才能够把这个旧的衣服脱掉，穿上新的。
Then only we can remove the old self and put on the new man.
所以当黑暗临到的时候，杀长子之灾，第十灾。
So when the plate of darkness comes, the coming of the tenth plate, killing of firstborn.
我们才能够兴起发光。
Then only we can arise and shine.
为什么要兴起发光呢
？Why we must arise and shine?
那我们再看 next.当上帝关灯的时候呢，也是我们做工的时候。
When God lights off, it's also the time for us to work.
这个就是马太福音四章十六节。那坐在黑暗里的百姓看见了大光，坐在死荫之地的人有光发现照着他们。从那时候，耶稣就传起道来说：“天国近了，你们应当悔改。”
In Matthew 4 verse 16, the people who sat in darkness have.Seen a great light, and upon those who sat in the region and shadow of death, light has dawned. From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, "Repent, the kingdom of heaven is at hand."
我相信第十灾杀长子之灾来到的时候，这个世界肯定是一片哀嚎。
When the tenth plague, the killing of firstborn, came upon the world, I believe it's going to be devastating.
那就是上帝说，我关灯。
That's the time the Lord say, I will off the light.
那就是埃及的第十灾杀长子之灾。
That is the template of Egypt.
我们会看到很多人坐在黑暗里，坐在死荫之地。
We will see many people sat in the darkness and have also the shadow of death.
Next. 在黑暗中的人看见了大光的时候，
Those who sat in the darkness have seen a great light.
当上帝的关灯的时候呢，在黑暗中，黑暗中的人看见大光。
In the darkness, the people can see the great light.
黑暗中人发现了我们光明之子啊。
In the darkness, that's where people can see us as a Christian, as the children of light.
如果你现在在第九灾。这个的黑暗之灾，你没有来教会兴起发光。
If during the plate of darkness you do not come to the house of the Lord and to arise and shine,
你有 handphone 又不 charge 电。
You have a handphone and you don't charge the power.
Low bat 怎么样用啊
？Low bat you cannot use the handphone.
当全部的人需要用 handphone 的时候，你也有 handphone 啊。
When everybody needs to use a handphone, you have a handphone.
不过你的 handphone 没有电哦。
But your handphone does not have power.
全部的人都没有电哦。
Everyone do not have the power.
Only the children of light.
Only the children of light.
我们有电哦。
We have the power.
当我的 handphone 在全部的人没有电的时候，我的 handphone 重要吗？
If all the people do not have the power in their handphone and only mine have the power, does it make a difference?
当我的 handphone 有 signal 有 light， 全部人都来发现这个光啊！
And everybody will recognize and they will come to my handphone because of the light。
我现在跟人家传耶稣，哎呀，咪搞我啊，冇同我讲耶稣啦。
Now I tell people about Jesus, and people will tell me, don't tell me about Jesus。
不过，当黑暗来到杀长子之灾来到的时候，我跟人家传耶稣，人家会说跟我讲多一点。
But when the template comes, the people will be able to attentive to the gospel, and they want to know more about Jesus.
那个时候的分别就大了。
That's the very different at that time.
我们再看到说，在死荫幽谷的人有光发现照着他们。
Those who sat in the shadow of death, light has dawned.
刚才是黑暗中人发现我有光。
Just now, I was saying that in the darkness, people
discovered
the light in us.
啊，因为我发光了吗
？Because I shine.
然后在死荫幽谷的
，But in the shadow of death.
那就是说，严重的
，Those that are really in trouble.
他不能够发现到我的
，They cannot recognize the light.
我找他
，We will go and look for him.
说有光发现。照着他们，我找他。
We go and look for that person and we shine on that person.
我为他祷告。
We pray for him.
然后呢，他那个字 dawn，
dawn。
啊，这个字的希腊文呢叫做 an at alo。啊，它的希腊文 an at alo 就是 cause to arise， 使你兴起。什么意思？那些严重的要自杀的，在那边呢，已经气心了。
Those who are already in a really, really bad situation, those that depressed, those that suicidal, we need to go and look for them.
那个叫做死荫幽谷的。
Those are considered in the death of shadow of death.
我们这些已经兴起发光了。
We are the one that arise and shine.
Battery charged 了的。
Our battery is full charge.
那我们去找他。
We need to go and look for this kind of people.
我们带着上帝的权柄能力为他祷告。
We go with the power and authority of Jesus to help them.
圣经说什么？神迹奇事就随着我们了。
The Holy Spirit say that the signs and wonders will follow us.
这个就是时候了。
This is the time.
你和我如果在这个第九灾没有做好准备
，If we at this night plate do not prepare ourselves.
两年的 lockdown 使你不能够，也不会来教会了。
2 years lockdown caused you not to come to the church.
你已经觉得去教会，哎，我在家里面看啊，喝咖啡不是更爽
？Yeah, it's so comfortable to worship the Lord in the house. You can have coffee at home.
你们这边是 fortnightly 纪念组了是吗
？Yeah, alternately.
好，你们说两个星期，那两个星期我们在教会摆饼喝杯的时候，你在家里面有没有准备饼和杯啊
？When we have communion at church, do you prepare your communion at home?
没有的话，你已经多久没有纪念主了啊
？If you do not do that, how long you do not remembering the Lord?
为什么主耶稣那么的吩咐我们要纪念我
？Why the Lord keep remind us to remember Him?
主耶稣2000多年前早已经知道会有 lockdown， 我们会不纪念他的。
The Lord already know after 2000 years we will have this lockdown and we will not remember Him.
两年而已，我们就不再纪念他了。
And we already not remembering the Lord.
你已经多久没有拜饼喝杯了啊
？How long you have not have your communion with the Lord?
就好像你已经有多久没有去看你的爸爸妈妈了
？It's like how long have you not visiting your parents?
我们跟父母说，我们孝顺父母。
We tell our parents that we honor them.
我们跟上帝说，我们敬拜。
We tell the Lord that we worship you.
他救我们从死里得永生。
The Lord saved us from the shadow of death.
我们难道不听他的吩咐来纪念他吗
？Why we do not listen to him and to honor him after we have been saved?
况且来纪念他，又建立了好习惯，使光照我们。
When we come to the house of the Lord, we build the habit that we allow the Lord.The light of the Lord shine upon us.
我们有了这个光，我们能够让人家发现到我们的存在。
When we have the light, we will shine around the people, and people will recognize us as the children of light.
我们就有那个机会跟人家传福音。
That's when we have the opportunity to share the gospel.
当黑暗来到时候，我们也有权柄能力去为人家祷告。
When the power of darkness came upon the earth, we still have the power and authority to pray for those who are in trouble.
这个就是我们若在这样的时刻没有了这个的好习惯。
If we do not build this good habit of coming to the house of the Lord,
当黑暗临到的时候，我们跟一切的人一样，我们也消失了。
When the power of darkness come upon us, we will be like the same as those that do not know the Lord.
OK， 我讲了这边都讲完了。
I have finished my preaching。
不过呢，我这样回去了不公平了嘛。
If I just go back like that, it's not fair。
因为我给了你 problem without solution。
I give you the problem, but I do not provide the solution。
好，我们讲一讲，哎呀，祷告啊，要读经啊。
We keep telling you that you need to pray, you need to read the word。
谁不知道？
Who doesn't know?
牧师不讲了多少次了？祷告啊，读经啊。
Yeah, I don't know how many times I've been hearing this.
你要来教会啊。
You must come to the church.
那为什么人还是不来教会啊
？Why people still don't come to the church?
为什么人还是不祷告啊
？Why people still do not pray?
为人还是不读圣经啊
？Why people still do not read the word?
因为我们软弱咯。
Because of our weaknesses.
Next, 我必须要讲完这个，我才可以回槟城呢。
I must finish this to before I go back to Penang.
因为我不讲完它，主耶稣一定不让我回槟城的。
Yeah, if I don't complete this, the Lord will not allow me to go back.
他说：“靠着圣灵，随时多方祷告祈求，并要在此警醒不倦，为众圣徒祈求。”
Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to the end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints.
但其实就是告诉我们方言祷告嘛，是不是
？Yeah, that is the meaning of praying in the spirit.
Next, 罗马书8:26，况且我们的软弱有圣灵帮助，我们本不晓得当怎样祷告，只是圣灵亲自用说不出来的叹息替我们祷告，鉴察人心的晓得圣灵的意思，因为圣灵照着神的旨意替圣徒祈求。
Romans 8:26, likewise, the Spirit also helped in our weaknesses, for we do not know what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groaning which cannot be uttered. Now, he who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God.
Now, 这两段经文告诉我们 方言祷告的重要。
Yeah, these two verses tell us the importance of praying in spirit.
我简短的来说。
I will summarize this.
今天我说，谁能够一天用方言祷告半个小时？举手。
Who can pray in tongue half an hour?
Continuously, or
continuously half an hour. Put out your hand.
啊，那不要了 ，embarrassed 了。不多了 ，OK， 不多了。
Not many of us can do that.
可以祷告半个小时，很厉害吗？
If you can pray in the spirits for half an hour, are you very good?
Nothing, you know. 没有什么的。
It means nothing.
不过呢，不是很多人可以做得到。
But not many people can do it.
因为我们要做工了吗
？Because we need to work.
家庭主妇啊，做工啊，
housewife,
等等啊。
Work.
Yeah. 我们 pastor 可以啦，在 office 祷告祷告咯。
But pastor can do it lah because they are full time.
其实我们也可以的。
But we also can.
我就是也我也跟上帝讲，我说主啊，我可以咯。哦，那做工的怎么样祷告？那人家用方言祷告，在 office 方言祷告，老板炒你鱿鱼了，方言祷告。
I also ask the Lord, I can do it because I'm the pastor. But what about others who are working?Okay, they can't do it in the office.
上帝给了我一个亮光。
Wow, God give me a light.
他说：“为什么你不能够在一个小时里面，每十五分钟你用三十秒或者是一分钟方言祷告？”
Oh, why can't you use every 15 minutes, 30 seconds to pray in the spirit, pray in tongue?
Every one hour. Four times.
Every 1 hour, you pray in tongue four times.
每一个小时四次。
Every
三十秒。
Every hour four times, and each time 30 seconds.
一天。
One day.
十二个小时好了。
12 hours.
多少啦？超过半个小时。
It's over 30 minutes.
是不是？所以每一个人其实真的我们是可以做，轻易做得到。
This is so easy for us to be able to practice.
你只是要有这个习惯就可以了。
You just need to build this habit.
当然，你开始的时候会忘记。
Yeah, at first you might forget.
哦，可能你两个小时才想到一次。
Yeah, maybe after 2 hours only you'll be able to do it once.
哦，没有关系，慢慢哦，慢慢哦。
But it's okay, just continue, slowly build the habit.
一个小时，四次，三十秒祷告。
1 hour, 4 times of 30 seconds of praying in tongue.
而且现在啊，又戴着 mask 哦。
But now wearing the mask.
你 speak in tongue, no one know 啊。
When you pray in tongue, also no one will know.
啊，多好。
That's so good.
那我们在缅甸的mission fund啊，我们在缅甸也有我们的财团基金啊。
Yeah, they also have a collection for the Myanmar mission.
所以我是跟弟兄姐妹们这样讲的。
I tell all my brother and sister in church.
这一个我们说给缅甸的儿童早餐。
We give to the ministry in Myanmar to provide breakfast for the children.
我只要求一个会友呢30令吉而已。
I only request 30 ringgit per member.
多我也不要，一个人30。
One person 30 ringgit.
Maximum.
Maximum.You can give less than 30 ringgit.
所以差不多90多%的 church member 都有参与的。
Yeah, over 90% of my members participate in this ministry.
我觉得这样好过呢，一个人给300块。
It's even better than one person give 300 ringgit.
我要呢，10个人参与30块。
I want 10% to be participate to give 30 ringgit.
如果我们呢一天12个小时里面能够4次一个小时30秒的祷告，这样的整天加起来半个小时，强过你一次祷告半个小时。
Yeah. Actually, when you pray 1 hour 4 times 30 seconds, is even better than you pray half an hour per day.
不是吗
？Yeah.
叫你。祷告半个小时一天是难的。
What if I want you to pray in tongue half an hour? It's very difficult for many of us.
不过呢，一个小时4次30秒是很容易的。
But 1 hour 4 times 30 seconds is easy to practice.
Okay, 32nd. Shalabarakimi kianturumui surampa karanti kirianda. Eshalama ramba karama shakaranta karina masoloboronto. Ekinama kurumpa kanama saraba kariande. Takalama shakarampe kanama san solomonundo. Karobinama kilama salayantromo kurukurundo. Takarama shalaba kiroma do kilambronto. Kirama shakirianda lama. 32nd. 我看着那个钟。 等一下，然后后面那个滴滴滴滴滴滴滴，红色的滴了，等一下，就这样简单呢。
That is how easy is it?
One hour.
Four times. Four times.
30秒.
30 seconds.
一天12个小时.
One day 12 hours.
可能他用我们4个星期、5个星期，我们建立了这个习惯.
Maybe it will use 4 to 5 weeks to build this habit.
OK， 当我们有了这样的一个的习惯，当上帝关灯的时候，我们永远 just in 啊。
Yeah， when we develop this habit， when the light off， we already have that power。
我们的 handphone
is always with power。
你晚上睡觉，你一定会 just in 的嘛？ Yeah， 为什么？习惯哦。
Yeah， when at night you have a habit to charge your handphone。
那我们这个身体 spiritual body 也是要 charge 电啊。
Even our spiritual body also need to be charged.
如果一直叫你们要读经啊，祷告，我们软弱不能。
If I keep telling you to pray, to read the word, to we are very weak, we can't do it.
不过呢，上帝给我们办法。
But the Lord give us a formula, a way to do it.
轻而易举，每一个人都做得到的，一天半个小时的祷告。
It's very simple, and every one of us can do it.
是你要不要而已哦。
It's your choice and decision whether you want to do it or not.
不是可以不可以啊。
It's not about whether you can or cannot.
是你要不要。
If you whether you want it or you do not want it.
我鼓励大家。
I encourage all of you.
我希望呢，我们在没关灯之前做好了扎实的习惯。
I encourage all of you to prepare while the light is still on to build this habit in us. So that we can be charged every day.
让我们一起站立，我们祷告。
Let us all stand.
主耶稣，我感谢您今天早上您自己的话语在我们当中。
Lord, we thank you for your word this morning.
谢谢您这样的光照亮着我。
Thank you for your light that shined upon us.
求你帮助我们。
Help us, Lord.
帮助软弱的我们。
Help us in our weaknesses.
就好像你给我们的方法一样。
It's like the way how you have given us the solution.
我们听到了。
We hear you, Lord.
我们也要尝试。
We want to do it.
求你帮助我们。
Help us, O God.
每一个小时。
Every hour.
4次30秒的祷告。
Four times and 30 seconds of praying in tongues.
主啊，让我们建立这样的好习惯。
Lord, help us to build this habit.
好让你关灯的时刻。
So that when the light off.
主啊，我们继续发光。
We will still continue to shine.
我们能够让这些黑暗中的人发现到我们是光明之子。
We will let all the people around us to see that we are the children of light.
我们也能够带着权柄能力去照耀那些软弱的人。
We can shine the light, O God, to those who are in the shadow of death.
主啊，帮助我们。
Lord, help us, O Lord.
我们愿意。
We are willing, O Lord.
如此的跟随你。
We want to follow you.
不管是黑暗或者是光明。
Whether it's in the light or in the darkness.
保守我们的心如摩西的心。
Preserve our heart so that we have a heart of Moses.
我们今天悔改在你面前。
We want to repent of ourselves before you today.
我们不想如法老一样继续的滥用恩典。
We do not want to be like Pharaoh to continue to misuse your grace.
谢谢你今天早上再一次向我们说话。
Thank you, O God, that your words speak to us this morning.
让软弱的我们再一次蒙您扶持。
Let our witness, O God, be
uphold
in your name.
奉耶稣基督的名祷告。
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
我们谢谢 Jacqueline。
Thank you, Pastor Ben, for bringing us the word in such with such clarity and with such impact. And I think Jack has done a great job in translating. He has made it so clear for us. And let's take heed of this word that we have heard. Let's prepare ourselves, yeah, before the lights off. And it is really through the constant practices that we do every day that we know God is renewing, God is transforming us every day. You know, the Bible in Romans 12:2 says that do not be conformed to the world, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind. So let's do it bit. Let's do it bit by bit. Let's do it constantly. And before we know it, before the lights off, we are all well prepared. And when the lights off in the darkness, we can be the lights to the world and to shine for Jesus. Amen. Can I have the slide? Our hope is not in a new year, but it's the one who makes all things new. Amen. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he's a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. May the strength of the Lord sustain us. May the power of God preserve us. May the hands of God protect us, especially against COVID. And may the way of God direct us. And may the love of God compel us to love and to forgive others. Amen. God bless you. Have a great week ahead. Amen. We live and die, but in the sun.